Hello, good evening. My name is Aisha Addo, and I am the host of this year's GUBA 2021 Red Carpet, where we're celebrating the courage and resilience and accomplishment of African women worldwide. How are you feeling being at the GUBA Awards 2021?
I think it's fantastic. I've never had the opportunity to attend GUBA Awards. It's been in the UK and in the US. It's the first time on the continent of Africa in Ghana, so I'm really excited.
And my name is Harriet Thompson. I'm the British High Commissioner to Ghana. I'm so glad to be here. The first time that these awards have ever been hosted in Africa is right here in Ghana. And we're celebrating strong, courageous women, so it couldn't be better.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're welcome to the GUBA Awards 2021, a celebration of the world's greatest women, our Yaa Asantewaa of the world.
You are the infamous, the amazing Mr. Rocky Dawoodi. How are you feeling today?
I am feeling very, very good because it's a day that we're not only honoring the culture of Ghana, but we're also honoring the history of Ghana. So I think that Ghana is really taking a leadership role by honoring what Yaa Asantewaa contributed.
You are one of our awardees tonight for the GUBA 2021 Awards. How does that make you feel?
You know, I hope throughout life we can merit those wonderful honors to be here in Mother Ghana, celebrating with all of you. It is I who's excited and honored to be amongst you.
My name is Diane Karusisi. I'm the CEO of Bank of Kigali. I feel happy to be part of this colorful event. I feel grateful that people can recognize me even far away because I come from, you know, Eastern Africa.
I am so honored to be celebrated tonight, and I hope it's an example to other young women coming up about what they can do.
I want each and every African to understand that it's very possible for Africa to unite and build itself.
Tonight, this honor is for all the young people who think that life is behind them.
Good evening, Africa. Let's get to work and let's transform our continent and the world at it. Thank you so much.
Excited as I see all the dress, costumes, the rich culture that is here in Africa and in Ghana.
Nana Yaa Asantewaa is someone whose legacy goes before us, and I know that for us, this is the time that we are beginning our march on the world. We won't give up until the end. Thank you.
Dentaa, when you go before, mommy and the IGP, Masha Ghana, Mayan, Masha Africa.
When we talk about Nana Yaa Asantewaa, we're talking about resilience. We're talking about power. A resounding round of applause for the land on which we stand, the land on which we sit. A resounding round of applause for the continent of Africa, the most powerful continent, arguably the one to watch. Tonight, GUBA is home to Africa!
Recognizing and celebrating a global innovation, ingenuity, and excellence for the past 10 years, the GUBA Awards has presented over 100 awards to leading African businesses and distinguished personalities. Today, the spirit of GUBA is spreading across the African continent, seeking to grow, unite, and build Africa, to serve as a link to connect Africa to the diaspora and harness the power of our shared vision to advance the continent. Tonight, We celebrate a legacy of courage and resilience that continues to inspire us a people. We celebrate 100 years of the death of Nana Yaa Asantewaa. We celebrate excellence. Welcome.
From our guest on what makes them courageous and resilient, GUBA 2021.
You've been kept down for too long. Stay now, please. Say I am free. Don't forget, you are welcome home.
Forward, we have to be brave enough to do the things necessary in order to get ahead. You know, Africans, black people around the world are resilient people. So I think that having this theme is perfect because we are all being courageous, doing the things necessary to move us into the future, because Africa is the future as far as I'm concerned.
It's a day that we're not only honoring the culture of Ghana, but we're also honoring the history of Ghana and also the power of the contribution of women to Ghana. So our national identity has women at the foundation. So this is the time that, you know, the whole world is recognizing that, you know, Africa cannot move forward without going back and recognizing that. So I think that Ghana is really taking a leadership role by honoring, you know, what Yaa Asantewaa contributed to our country and also contributed in energizing a nation to go out there and take back their sovereignty. And I think that it's also a testament for the times in which we are, that our women are important.
Ladies and gentlemen, a resounding round of applause for the land on which we stand, the land on which we sit. A resounding round of applause for the continent of Africa. Oh yes! Arguably the most powerful continent, arguably the one to watch. And if you think the continent of Africa is the one to watch, then how do you feel about the continent's women? How do you feel about African women? And how do you feel about the world's women? Because, ladies and gentlemen, when we talk about Nana Yaa Asantewaa, we're talking about resilience. We're talking about power. We're talking about the ability to look at danger in the face and fight for your people, fight for what you believe in, and ultimately lead your people. My name is Anita Erskine, and tonight, GUBA is home to Africa! Oh, yes.
My name's Harriet Thompson. I'm the British High Commissioner to Ghana. I'm so glad to be here. The first time that these awards have ever been hosted in Africa is right here in Ghana. And we're celebrating strong, courageous women, so it couldn't be better. I think the work that GUBA does to connect the diaspora back with the motherland, that's really epitomized in this evening. This event that started out overseas and now is actually happening back here in Ghana. It's brilliant.
I call it a bit of a full circle because it started in the UK. I was there, we went to the US, and now we've traveled to Ghana, and it's come home. So I'm really happy to be here, and even more special, this edition is dedicated to women.
We are here with one of our lovely board members, Miss Cynthia Kwaku, and one of the managing partners of CQE Legal. How are you feeling being here at the 2021 GUBA Awards?
Yaa Asantewaa represents so much. And the fact that she had been left almost uncelebrated had to be corrected. So for me, when I, being a board member, I knew about the decision to do the CS1 on her anniversary. I embraced it, and I thought it was a fantastic idea. But to see it actually materialize, I think I'm feeling a bit surreal.
This feels great. It feels wonderful. And I have to say a big thank you to Her Excellency, the First Lady of the land, Mrs. Rebecca Akufo-Addo. And you lead a powerful army of women, ma'am. We say a big thank you. Auntie Frema, our Chief of Staff, and we can't help but call you Auntie Frema because you are a mother, you are a nurturer to us all, and we thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight is about looking at the African women, looking at the world's women, looking at African women in the world, and their ability to not only hold the flag of Ghana high, their ability to not only bring Africa pride, but their ability to be examples to us all. Ladies and gentlemen, you're welcome to the GUBA Awards 2021, a celebration of the world's greatest women, our Yaa Asantewaas of the world. Tonight is going to be great, and tonight has just begun.
In memory, time, and space, the African woman has been mother, she's been earth, she's been the womb, she's been the tomb, she's this timeless span that we live, and when we are done, all our life truncates, she opens up and takes us in, back into mother's womb. Yet, in all of this life, Father Africa has been very absent. Let us not get into the issues which have made him absent. But mother has always been at the warfront. And when she steps out, she wears a smile enough to sneer all the many battles that we have to face. From the center of the world, I present to you beautiful collection, timeless piece across memory, time, and future, as crafted by Diaba Sewa.
Thank you.
all the dress, costumes, the rich culture that is here in Africa and in Ghana. I'm really proud to be part of all that is going on here today.
Missy Anyang from Zona Tech Ghana Limited. We are so excited to have you here, and you look absolutely amazing in your kente.
It's so interesting to me. This is the first time I'm wearing kente. It's so amazing. And I have to let my tailor do it for me. It's so nice.
Wow, this year's theme is around courage and resilience. What does that mean to you?
I think that is my spirit. Because I'm a woman, I'm running a big company, and I created that company. So I'm the Yaa Asantewaa spirit.
Wow, yes, give us that Yaa Asantewaa spirit. So we're finally here. We're celebrating the women. What is one thing that you're looking forward to tonight?
I think this is going to be inspiring for a lot of women going forward. So it's about amplifying that resilience and amplifying the awesomeness that comes out of this event tonight. And thank you, Dentaa, for organizing this.
So you happen to be one of our amazing sponsors. So how does that make you feel being able to experience this year's awards in person?
Honestly, it's an amazing feeling. I feel like the KGL Foundation really aligns with what the GUBA Awards is trying to do. And I could not be prouder to be at this event here in Ghana. So it's an amazing feeling.
Amazing. Well, thank you so very much for your sponsorship and for being here. Mr. Kabute, Ghana's number one MC. How are you, sir? And how are you feeling being at the GUBA Awards 2021?
I feel absolutely proud. I feel so vibrant. The color, the energy, the vibrancy, you know, you can just almost feel a real strong connection to our roots, and it's just absolutely lovely. I feel fantastic being here. I think it's been a perfect night already for me, so I can't wait for the rest that will evolve inside. Yes.
I present to you one and only GUBA Awards. Beautifully crafted armor for the contemporary woman with the spirit of Yaa Asantewaa. Essence of the soul, sweet music from the heart of the Imbira, all the way from Zimbabwe. Hope Masike.
This is my first time at the GUBA Awards, and I must say you guys are doing an impeccable job. You make it look so easy, honestly, but it's really fun so far.
Honestly, I feel amazing. I'm glad it's finally come to Accra. We've waited long enough, and finally we're here. This, everything happening tonight, this is what I stand for. This, like, encapsulates all that I want to be, all that I am and want to be and more, honestly. And I couldn't be more proud to be here. I mean, it feels so good being a strong woman myself. And I mean, Yaa Asantewaa, seriously, she was a warrior, a leader. She brought people together, you know, and that's what I want to be.
I feel so excited. I've been to two GUBA Awards in the UK. So coming to Ghana, I'm super excited.
I feel amazing. Like, it's more than I could have thought or imagined coming all the way from the US yesterday. So I am absolutely excited.
What is one thing that you absolutely love about Ghana?
I felt at home the minute I got off the plane. The minute I got off the plane, people were saying, welcome home. And my friends that had already been to Ghana tried to explain it. You can't. You have to experience it for yourself.
Thank you, Ghana. Thank you, GUBA Awards. Thank you, Nana Yaa Asantewaa.
And with that said, ladies and gentlemen, please allow me to bring you to our very first set of awards tonight. The GUBA Nana Yaa Asantewaa Women of Spirit is for these amazing market women who have brought so many more market women up along with them. Ladies and gentlemen, let's go straight into our first set. Please allow me to present our presenters for this category, Richard Osei Anani, Head of Corporate Affairs, Exim Bank, and Cynthia Kwaku, GUBA Advisory Board Member.
GUBA Nana Yaa Asantewaa, Woman of Spirit. The GUBA Nana Yaa Asantewaa, Woman of Spirit celebrates four Ghanaian women who have endured challenges and developed their resilience through life. Today, these women play a significant part in advancing the interests of market women across Ghana.
The first recipient of the GUBA Nana Yaa Asantewaa Woman of Spirit Award is Hajia Rabiatu Abubakari from the Northern Region.
My name is Jalil Zakaria. I work for SMV Ghana as the project manager for the two scale projects. I have known Hajia Rabi for the past 9 years. She rose from a production manager in a company to become her own manager.
Hajia Rabiatu Abubakari is a very good friend of mine. She came up with an idea of shea butter production. She has over 3,000 women. She farms 500 acres.
She's introduced women into financial inclusion. She's the reason many more women in Northern Ghana, especially in the shea sector, have food on their tables. She is the reason many children have gone to school.
She has over 50 students. She's paying their school fees. I would say universities, training, college, and the rest.
Her business model is one that integrates the poor, and then women in particular, in the value chain.
If we were to have five of Asia in the Northern region, we wouldn't have been talking of poverty again.
Your role thus far, for me, is an example of what Yaa Asantewaa stood for. Congratulations, Asia.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next is in this category, allow me to welcome Gabby Ochidako and his co-presenter, the Minister of Works and Housing, the Honorable Francis Asenso Bwachi.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The second recipient for the GUBA Nanaya Santua Woman of Spirit Award is Madam Victoria Ama Biman Opong from the Ashanti region.
My name is Marie Christine Osei-Wusu. I'm a graduate nurse and a second year medical student of KNUS. Madam Victoria Opong is my mother.
Victoria and I have been friends for a long time. I remember her husband came back from the diaspora with illness, so all the family's financial burden fell on Ama.
My mother used to hawk abele on the streets. Through that, she was able to gather capital to establish a near empty shop that was handed over to her by my cousin.
She catered for all her children's upkeep and school fees, including her husband, from a mini shop she managed.
From petty trading, she has an engineer, a medical student, two teachers, and then one nutritionist.
When hardworking women are mentioned, Ama should not be eliminated. I'm happy that this Yaa Asantewaa Woman of Spirit honor has been bestowed on you.
On behalf of all your children, we would like to congratulate you on this award. We love you, we appreciate everything you've done for us, and you really deserve it.
God bless you. You've indeed reaped from your labor.
Now let's welcome Madam Victoria Ama Biman Opong.
Gentlemen, our next presenters from the GUBA Advisory Board, Steve Gray and John Carmichael.
Good evening. It gives me great pleasure to announce the third recipient of the GUBA Nanaya Asantewaa Women of Spirit is Margaret Adobea Asari from the Greater Accra region.
Margaret Asari is my sister and friend. We have been friends for the last 45 years. I have known Madam Asari for a very long time, since my childhood. Margaret Asari has worked incredibly hard.
We used to grow and harvest watermelons, tomatoes, and peppers. When there was a food shortage, she flew to Kumasi to procure corn and bought it instantly.
When things got hard, she sold most of her belongings, including her house. Even after such loss, she returned back to work even harder than before, and was able to purchase another land on which she built.
She raised 8 biological children, 2 stepchildren, and 5 from her siblings, totaling 15.
The work that men cannot do is what she does for strength.
Yaa Asantewaa spirit is exactly what Yaya possesses. Today, I am blessing Yaya. We call her Opaya. She is as courageous as Yaa Asantewaa.
I acknowledge your handiwork, the same courage shown by us as well. I bless you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the last in this category will be presented by real estate mogul, founder and CEO of Kwale's Group, Kwame Bediako, aka Cheddar, and of course, Nigerian actress, TV star, director extraordinaire, Chioma Akpoka.
Final recipient of the GUBA Award, Nanaya Asantewaa, Woman of Spirit, it's Mary Kramer.
And
honest, Voice Upon is my name, the Chief Executive Officer of Specialized Mineral Water and then the Group Chairman for Special Group of Companies. Madam Mary Pramai is my biological mom.
My name is Asantewaa Prempe. I'm a worker and I've known her for the past 25 years.
I'm Kweku Amwaku, a hotelier and a real estate developer. I'm her second child of her 6 children. She started as a small seamstress. When we entered secondary school, we had then moved from the villages to Accra, where she started running her various shops.
It's only a few people who started on the street to a shop like this.
We had a lot of shops both here and Kumasi. She was a big off-taker for most of the people who brought goods from Monrovia and UK.
All her children, when you look at them now, even including the grandchildren, are in good positions in terms of businesses and enterprises.
She depicts all the attributes of an entrepreneur. I picked a lot of things from her. I worked with her for almost 10 years. We all thank God that today she's still alive, and we thank GUBA for nominating her to be one of the recipients of this international award.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our final recipient of the GUBA Nana Yaa Asantewaa Woman of Spirit Award, Mary Pramang.
I'm very grateful for this honor bestowed on me. I thank you for honoring me. I am very sorry I could not join and celebrate with you tonight. I am extremely happy for honoring my work. My work being compared to Yaa Asantewaa's courage and resilience is not a mere feat. I am humbly honored. God has done a lot in my life, and I thank him for bringing me this far. I once again say thank you for this honor. God bless you.
And ladies and gentlemen, that brings us to the end of this category of the GUBA Nana Yaa Asantewaa Woman of Spirit.
And so the journey continued. Yaa, born on a Thursday, on the day that after battle we counted our losses, on the day that we lamented. But Yaa was worth the pain. Yaa was worth the tears. And so, many years, many centuries back, Yaa's continent, Africa, home, this place where it all began, this market of 9 moons, was ahead of its time. Yet we had to shed blood. We had to shed sweat. Fast forward into the future where I live. Yaa, a young warrior. A young warrior princess needs to find solutions for her people. And so she must travel through soul time, take that spiritual journey, and go and seek some answers. Do not ask me to be of help. We always consult Abrewetia. Abrewetia, Nana, Yaa, Asasewaa, Asantewaa, Abrefi, Koto, Kukudru, Fo. Lend me your ears, offer your eyes, and watch the story unfold so that in retelling, you will not miss the plot.
From a bonny abo, I'm an import to you. Request trust is your trust. Nipanina Bosabosa. Asante mind, yes, yeah, why you doko doko doko. I'm a dipati one cost you a drink. She up a 5 week catcher saying, Corey Bonimanquada. Yan share map wobble to grammar, drunk one genuine year for dear metimetim. Norris idea, Abraham Grinam. Sabi, yes, yeah, Bobbin, Chia Bobbin, yeah. Nigel Sapia, Bobby Fab, Bobby and Numedago Pramaso. Mia, Michasa, dear Samia, in me. I did say, Mia, I shan't my walk up. Impedin to say, anu wowe epetria esianamon ya mamenwasao.
Ebusu sebe na wabosi akwesikwa ko sene wan so bebi sasike dako fiase asante man kra ne nsunsun anokwa yesu wotia na fani breko mumien kai se isian ko a akwa dwane ipenisi ye jawa ni ye dia swao mumien kai so se ye ye osa intifuo ye fidudu amu ukuma pima
apimbeba
emra so se ye sorry ejina ho pinti kwasa kuji ye man me oba de nansumpo me tawo sai mu a dati inti mama kai se oba kukudufu bit na se a ne ye fra ne ya asantewa sorry di domenim ku ehe ku omna na mema atoba ha na sentri man kurai. I say, Nananum Kosa, no affair me, Namidane, Machima, Wania, with Dimitri Miji.
Oh, they jump way, what Mamma Street? What ya, or they jump way? A poor bit of what ya massa, or they jump way? What Mamma Slow? Oh, they jump way, what Mamma Street? What ya, or they jump way? A poor bit of what ya massa, or they jump way? What Mamma Slow?
I have felt your presence for a while now. Step out of the shadow and into the light. You are not from here.
Queen Mother, indeed, I am not from here. But I am born of here. I am from your generation in the future. We are faced with an imminent threat from outside forces. And that is why I have traveled here to find answers. Queen Mother, what should I tell my people to do?
Yeah, if you have traveled through time to find answers on this matter, then you have wasted your time. For you have always had the answers with you. You have African blood, are you not? Then go. Go and tell your people that the spirit of courage and resilience that inspired the people of Asanteman exists within them. And it is in that same strength the people of your time must embrace. And it will be the same strength your progenitors will stand upon to face any challenge that might come their way. Take this.
You would know what to use it for when the time comes. Now go. Go and take charge. Go!
Our culture. It's a really beautiful occasion.
So you are one of the awardees for tonight's event. How does that make you feel being recognized for who you are, but then also for your courage and resilience?
I feel grateful that people can recognize me even far away because I come from, you know, Eastern Africa. So I'm happy to be here and to be able to share my experience with people here.
Amazing. Congratulations, and we hope you enjoy the show. And we're so happy to have you here tonight. How are you feeling about receiving the award today?
You know, I hope throughout life we can merit those wonderful honors to be here in Mother Ghana, celebrating with all of you. It is I who's excited and honored to be amongst you.
From the standpoint of women empowerment. And women empowerment is a major thing that we do in UNFPA. So that's why we are proud sponsors of GUBA.